All right, Keith, thanks a lot. Tupelo's mayor is encouraging the Lee County Sheriff and the Board of Supervisors to scale back plans for a new law enforcement facility and avoid a tax hike to pay for it.
Mayor Jason Shelton's remarks on social media came one day after a public forum on the proposed $51 million project.
As WCBI's Allie Martin has, he will have more now on this growing rift.
Tupelo Mayor Jason Shelton and Lee County Sheriff Jim Johnson both agree on one thing, the long overdue need for a new law enforcement facility. But when it comes to the tax hike needed to fund the project, Mayor Shelton took to Facebook to say he believes a new jail could be built without a tax increase, especially since the city pays Lee County $25 per inmate per day to house those arrested by the Tupelo Police Department.
Not only paying their property tax and car tax that go towards the jail, but on top of that paying $750,000 a year for the jail that only has a $2.7 million budget total. So, you know, the city of Tupelo is funding, I would say, 50% of the jail already.
Answering the mayor's post, Sheriff Johnson took to Facebook and said the proposal will be revised to reduce bed count and remove the Tupelo Municipal Court from the plans. Even with a scaled-down concept, the sheriff says a tax increase will be needed.
I pay taxes. It is ridiculous for us to have to pay to house inmates, but it is a fact of life. You pay taxes to get services, and that's one service we have to provide.
Sheriff Johnson says housing Tupelo's inmates is not one service the county must provide. According to the 1995 interlocal contract signed by both parties when the jail opened, the county can stop accepting Tupelo's prisoners only under two conditions. If the city falls behind on its per diem payments to the county for holding its prisoners, or if the agreement is terminated by either party. Sheriff Johnson did just that a few months ago when he sent the city a letter saying he was rescinding the agreement to keep Tupelo inmates in the Lee County Jail. That won't go into effect until April 2019.
That's going to allow Tupelo to build their own jail, house their own inmates, and put a city court, if that's what they choose, and operate that thing on an annual basis.
But Mayor Shelton says a city jail is not even on the drawing board.
We had our own jail at one time. It was a duplication of services between the city and county. If it was the absolute last resort, I suppose we could do that, but that's not something that is being looked at right now.
The sheriff says the 600-bed jail with a morgue, crime lab, offices, and justice court will serve the county for decades.
And the difference is he's a lawyer and I'm a sheriff. I've run a jail for 15 years. I know the ins and outs, front and back. I don't go down there and tell him how to run the city hall. I don't tell him how to run the mayor's office. And if he or any other municipality expects me as the sheriff to house their prisoners, we're going to play by my rules.
Lee County supervisors will consider a scaled-down proposal for the law enforcement complex during their next meeting on Monday. They can also vote for the 600-bed option. In Tupelo, I'm Allie Martin, WCBI News.
According to the 1995 contract, if the county uses the current jail for any other purpose over a two-year period, then ownership of the property where the jail is located will go to the city.